All right, in this video, I'm going to show you how to generate the timing diagram from your flip-flops and from your other inputs. So in this one, we are dealing with a D flip-flop that's asynchronous. So it's an asynchronous D flip-flop. Okay, what does that mean? It means that it has a preset and clear, and they happen, and the timing diagram Q will respond to them no matter whether the edge of the clock comes by or not. Okay, and remember, for a D flip-flop, Q follows D, and then if you change the preset to 0, because these are active low, see they have bubbles, so they're active low, okay, then Q becomes 1, clear 0, Q equals 0. You can't have them both set equal to 0. So the bubbles mean that this one was active low. All right. There's no bubble on the clock, so it means it responds to the rising edge. Okay. So let's look at this. So the first thing I'd want to do on my timing diagram is go ahead and mark all my rising edges. So I know I have to look there. That's a rising edge. This is a rising edge. This one, this one, this one, and this one. Okay, those are all rising edges of the clock, and I've marked all those. The other place that I'm going to respond is when the preset or the clear go to 0. So I'm going to mark those too. All right, and I'm just going to mark those like this so that I'll know that I have to look at them there. Here. And here. Alright, so let's start to take a look at what this timing diagram might look like. So I get to the first rising edge of the clock. I look at preset and clear. They're both 1, so they're both turned off. Alright, so this is 1, so Q will be 1. Alright, so it's going to go up to 1 and start to travel across. Okay. I get to the edge of the clock now, and I look back to see what is happening, okay? And when I look here, okay, D is gone to 0, so Q would go to 0, and it's going to go down. And now it's going to travel across, and I get to a place where the preset has been activated. So the preset's been activated, and what's going to happen? The preset goes to 0, so Q's going to go to 1 immediately. It's asynchronous. It doesn't wait for the clock. So it's going to go back up, and it's going to travel across. Now, it doesn't respond here when I deactivate it, all right? It stays there. It's only triggered by me making the preset equal to 0, not by me making the preset 1. All right, I come here. I look at my preset and my clear are both at 1, so they're inactive, they're turned off, all right? And so I look at D, and D is 0, okay? Then, so it's going to go down, and it's going to start to travel across here. No other events influencing it. I get here, I look at D. D changed back here, so I'm going to go high again, all right? And then I'm going to travel across. Uh-oh, I'm going to get to one of my presets or clears. Now my clear has been turned low, which turned it on, made it active because it was active low. And that's going to drive Q to 0 immediately, asynchronously. All right? And it's going to begin to travel across low. When I get here, the clear has been turned back to 1, so it's been inactivated again. D is 1, so I will go high again and follow out. So this is how you make a timing diagram for a flip-flop.